All right, I want to work an example for you guys where we have an absolute value equation, but we've got a lot of stuff around it. All right, so you can see how I have this minus 15, I have this 5 in front, and a lot of times when this happens, you guys aren't sure where to start. Okay, so I will tell you, we want to get this absolute value all by itself on one side of the equation. All right, where I'm going to think of it as though it by itself is a letter or variable. So what does that mean I need to do? Well, that means the first thing I need to do is to add 15 to both sides. So I keep my 5 times the absolute value expression, and I add 15 to both sides. All right, now I need to move this 5. How am I going to move that 5? I'm going to divide both sides by 5. And now I have an absolute value expression equals 3. All right, and what are the rules when we have an absolute value equation? It means we write two equations, and I need to solve 1 minus 4x equals 3, all right, the one that I see pretty much, and the other one is 1 minus 4x equals negative 3, all right? And so I'm just going to say for you guys, because this is a very common mistake, the only thing that became negative was this 3 on the right-hand side. I did not change a darn thing with the 1 minus 4x, okay? So please, please, please notice that, again, only this 3 became negative. All right, well, let's go ahead and solve this negative version. All right, how am I going to solve it? Well, I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides, and then I'm going to divide both sides by negative 4, and negative 4 divided by negative 4 just gives me 1. And then over here on the right side, I'm also going to subtract 1 and get negative 4x equals 2. Divide both sides by negative 4 gives me negative 2 over 4. All right, is that my final answer? Not quite. I can simplify this into negative 1 over 2. That's our final answer, negative 1/2 and 1.